Isney animations never have it easy. They have been accused of ethnic stereotyping and of having a white-centric worldview. But when they attempt to embrace other cultures, the studio is told off for appropriation. The latest entry, Moana, which is inspired by Polynesian mythology and culture, has attracted criticism for depicting Pacific Islanders as stereotypically overweight, and for selling a padded, tattooed bodysuit as a child's Halloween costume, which the studio hastily withdrew. Credit to Disney for even wading into these hazardous waters, then. And this seafaring adventure appears to take great pains to get it right, from the textile designs to the dance movements, the coconut-based crafts to the lovingly rendered turquoise seas. But there are other traditions Disney animations must respect. As one character says of our heroine, "You're in a dress and you've got an animal sidekick, you're a princess." Despite Moana's denials, this is a Disney princess movie, which means it has certain royal obligations to fulfill: a role model heroine, a magical quest, a wholesome message, a merchandisable animal sidekick, in this case, a supremely dumb chicken, and musical numbers that will pass the playground test. Some of them do. Hamilton's Lin-Manuel Miranda had a hand in the songwriter, and the earwormy "How Far I'll Go" is this year's "Let It Go." Moana, progressive paean to Polynesia, or another of Disney's cultural blunders? Read more. The course of the story is set by a prologue telling the legend of Maui, a trickster demigod who stole the goddess's fertility-giving heartstone, but then lost the magical fishhook that enabled him to transform into other animals. So when teenage Moana, voiced by newcomer Ali Cravalho, sees her implausibly contented pre-industrial society going into ecological meltdown, she knows what she must do. Her huge, overprotective father, who is the size of a large fridge, forbids anyone to sail beyond the reef, especially his daughter. But her more free-spirited grandma reveals to Moana her seafaring heritage, and beseeches her to ignore Dad, listen to her inner voice, and hit the high seas, preferably with an animal sidekick. Of course, she runs into Maui, a charming, slightly vain proto-surfer whose animated tattoos betray his bruised inner feelings. He wears his heart on his pecs, you could say. If Dad was a fridge, Maui is a small car. Moana's waist is about the same circumference as his wrist. That may be conceivably offensive, but it bears remembering that Maui is a demigod, not a representative mortal, and that he's voiced by ex-wrestler Dwayne The Rock Johnson, whose sport career was founded on his conspicuous lack of svelteness. Maui is only interested in getting back his lost fish hook. Some symbolism is universal, it seems, but with a mix of emotional empathy and wily deal-making, Moana enlists him on a seafaring mission that readily settles into the groove of an opposites attract rom-com road trip. The story takes some agreeably bizarre turns. There's a flotilla of coconut-clad little pirate creatures who seem like they've come out of Mad Max. And stealing the show is Flight of the Conchords' Jemaine Clement, who gets a cameo as a glam crustacean monster decked out like a giant glitter ball, whose musical tastes clearly include David Bowie and Christina Aguilera. It's best not to give too much away, but the fact that there's little else to give away is where Moana falls down. Moana's "Know Who You Are" message is the sort of thing we'd probably want our children to hear, and there's a pleasing resonance in the way the movie transmits ancient folk knowledge via digital means. But Disney has set a high standard lately. Frozen defied its fairy tale template by swerving into matters of sisterhood. Big Hero 6 pulled off a clever trans-Pacific cultural fusion, and this year's excellent Zootopia was both a snappy, original comedy and a valuable primer in identity politics. Moana never quite reaches these heights. Its cultural setting is fresh, its storytelling, less so. It navigates the reefs, but it doesn't discover a whole new world. Moana, progressive paean to Polynesia, or another of Disney's cultural blunders. Read more. The course of the story is set by a prologue telling the legend of Maui, a trickster demigod who stole the goddess's fertility-giving heartstone, but then lost the magical fishhook that enabled him to transform into other animals. So when teenage Moana, voiced by newcomer Ali Cravalho, sees her implausibly contented pre-industrial society going into ecological meltdown, she knows what she must do. Her huge, overprotective father, who is the size of a large fridge, forbids anyone to sail beyond the reef, especially his daughter. But her more free-spirited grandma reveals to Moana her seafaring heritage, and beseeches her to ignore dad, listen to her inner voice and hit the high seas, preferably with an animal sidekick. Of course, she runs into Maui, a charming, slightly vain proto-surfer whose animated tattoos betray his bruised inner feelings. He wears his heart on his pecs, you could say. If Dad was a fridge, Maui is a small car. Moana's waist is about the same circumference as his wrist. That may be conceivably offensive, but it bears remembering that Maui is a demigod, not a representative mortal, and that he's voiced by ex-wrestler Dwayne The Rock Johnson, whose sport career was founded on his conspicuous lack of svelteness. Maui is only interested in getting back his lost fish hook. Some symbolism is universal, it seems, but with a mix of emotional empathy and wily deal-making, Moana enlists him on a seafaring mission that readily settles into the groove of an opposites attract rom-com road trip. The story takes some agreeably bizarre turns. There's a flotilla of coconut-clad little pirate creatures who seem like they've come out of Mad Max. And stealing the show is Flight of the Conchords' Jemaine Clement, who gets a cameo as a glam crustacean monster decked out like a giant glitter ball, whose musical tastes clearly include David Bowie and Christina Aguilera. It's best not to give too much away, but the fact that there's little else to give away is where Moana falls down. 3,000 years ago, the greatest sailors in the world voyaged across the vast Pacific, discovering the many islands of Oceania. But then, for a millennium, their voyages stopped, and no one knows exactly why. From Walt Disney Animation Studios comes Moana, a sweeping, CG animated feature film about an adventurous teenager who sails out on a daring mission to save her people. During her journey, Moana, voice of Ali Cravalho, meets the mighty demigod Maui, voice of Dwayne Johnson, who guides her in her quest to become a master wayfinder. Together, they sail across the open ocean on an action-packed voyage, encountering enormous monsters and impossible odds, and along the way, Moana fulfills the ancient quest of her ancestors and discovers the one thing she's always sought, her own identity. Directed by the renowned filmmaking team of Ron Clements and John Musker, The Little Mermaid, Aladdin, The Princess and the Frog, produced by Osnat Schurer, Lifted, One Man Band, and featuring music by Lin-Manuel Miranda, Mark Mancina, and Opita Foai, Moana sails into U.S. theaters on November 23, 2016. So what if she'd rather be a sailor than a princess? Moana still rules. Contemporary Disney at its finest, a vibrantly rendered adventure that combines state-of-the-art CG animation with traditional storytelling and colorful characters, all enlivened by a terrific voice cast. Moana has a lot of the hallmarks of your classic Disney adventure: the goofy animal sidekicks, the feel-good messages, but its heroine is something new, a smart and fiery deviation from your standard European love-struck princesses. Moana keeps with the tradition that made Disney the leader in animated fairy and folk tales, and yet, showing a thoroughly modern touch, it's the first to do so without so much as suggesting a love interest. Much to its credit, the screenplay makes Moana an interesting, self-actualized character. She's not waiting around for a prince, and there's no question that her gender will stand in the way of inheriting the title of chief. A crowd-pleasing oceanic musical with big tunes and beguiling characters, Moana is likely to thwack a big smile on your face.